Coco. Welcome to this week's junior match of the day. We're at Preston Field for the William Hill Scottish Cup third round. It's the big one. It's Linlithgow versus Raith Rovers here at Preston Field. Team's just about to come out the tunnel. It's 3 minutes to kick off. Just panning around the crowd. It's a huge big crowd here today at Preston Field. Biggest I have ever seen in the Rose pitch. And the stand is packed, we're all ready to go. This is not one to miss. And out come the teams for this William Hill Scottish Cup third round game. Nice play by Linlithgow. It's played across to Callum Smith. Callum Smith is driving in on goal. He cuts, he shoots, and it's saved by the keeper. It's thrown out early to Anderson. Anderson's running up the line. Tommy Coyne tackles, gets the ball back, but it's a free kick. Callum plays it to Coco, plays it to Batchy, Batchy plays it to Roddy. Nice skill, one back, Coco wins it back. Roddy's in. Oh! Just past the post from Roddy McLennan. This is an amazing start from them. Close pressure by Raith Rovers. It's played back, now Rovers can get the ball back, but now Batchy's got it back from Linlithgow Rose. Batchy plays it to Roddy. Roddy keeps going. He's still going. Still! And it's saved by the keeper again. Tommy plays it to Roddy. Roddy's got it. Plays to Coco. Plays to Callum. Good play outside the box. Now Callum Smith. It's past one. Plays it out. Swip back in. Hit away again. Steps his run up. Plays it in. Towards Tommy Coyne. No. Spatchy. Oh, still there. That's a free kick on the edge of the box. And that is a great range for the Linlithgow Rose. Batchy's down. Well, it looks like he's going to be fine. Now this is some area for Linlithgow Rose. Coco's a good striker. Batchy's a good striker. Callum's good. Adam's good. Roddy's good. Doesn't like Roddy's going to play it though. Now it's either Coco or Adam. Most likely Coco. It looks like he wants to bend it in. Yep. It's Coco. Or Adam. Which one? Coco. Oh, and it's saved just at the back post. Done by Callum. He can counter now. Plays it up the line towards Roddy. Roddy's got the ball. It's 2v2 at the back. Cuts inside. Keeps going. Plays it for your Coco. Coco's in. Saved. And great pressure by Roddy. Coco. Plays it to Callum. Callum crosses it. Oh. Calm again. Plays it to Coco. Oh, just past the post from Coco. Half time. It's Linlithgow Rose now. Raith Rovers now. Raith Rovers to kick off the second half here at Preston Field. Raith Rovers kick off the second half here at Preston Field. It's hit along early. Richard McKillen clears it back to Michael. Keeper punts it up again. It's one. Back to Anderson. Plays it up. Headed away. And that's a free kick to Raith Rovers. Tommy out for a corner. Played in, Michaels. Great play, right up to Coco, holding, straight to the other keeper. Floyd up. Headed up. It's away. Richie, there's it to Roddy. Nice flick. Roddy, 4v4 at the back. Has options. Goes himself. Free kick. What will it be? What will the ref give? Yellow card. Now this is brilliant territory. We saw in the first half here, Coco nearly scored. It's more of Adam Nelson territory. Coco's over again with Batchy and Tommy. It's going to be Coco again, I think.
Push this stop!
Adam Nelson or Coco?
That's an Adam Nelson! That's an Adam Nelson! That's 25 yards! That's his range!
Rolls it. Tommy! Blocks.
It's an Adam Nelson! 25!
It's early. And he's offside. Coco, Tommy, Eddie back. Adam, Batchy. Oh, that's a mystical bounce to Roddy. Roddy Kearns. Fake shots. Plays it. Coco! Oh. Still going, Tommy Coyne. Crosses it. Out for a corner. It's played to Short. Oh. Straight to Michael. Nice head. Linlithgow really pushing on in the second half. Penalty, Raith Rovers. It's a dive though. Looks like it's a. Who's he going to give? Let's take a look at a replay.
No cross, guys, no cross! No cross! No cross!
Score 1-0 Raith Rovers. Adam, Roddy, plays it in. Oh. Callum, lose it out. Batchy, lose it in. Well cleared. Raith Rovers, 2-0 Raith Rovers. Raith Rovers are in. Hit over. Callum Smith on the drive, still going, goes down, loses it, full time, it's enough to lose now, Raith Rovers 2.
Very proud man tonight, Danny.
Martin, I can't praise the players enough. We've had to go about things differently than what we usually do, and what they've gave us is they do it every week. And I think it's important that people know that these guys on a Monday and a Thursday night, when Marcel and Alan came to the club, they've gave us everything. And we've got ourselves now to a level where I was quietly confident we could put a performance on today, and I've stressed to them all week and been very honest about it, but we had to adapt to how we went about it. If they didn't buy into it, we could have picked off 2, 3, 4 nil. They've bought into it big style, and the first half performance especially, we've created numerous chances. I think we've surprised a lot of people today, and there would obviously be a lot of neutrals at this game, and I think when Linlithgow Rose are the team that's going to take a lot of praise and credits out of this.
Talk us through how you set the team up, Danny, because I think a lot of people would have expected Linlithgow to pack the bus today, and although you worked out a way of denying time it and playing, Linlithgow were creating loads of chances and loads of possession. So talk us through how you had the team set up.
The way we set up, and it was explained to the players on Monday night, is we were going to set about it 4-3-3/4-5-1. Tommy Coyne and Callum Smith, the wide men, We're always going to push, try and push the fullbacks. If they were playing at the back, we had to press the fullbacks. Our fullbacks were then needing to press the wide man. But what we felt it gave us, and it probably opened a few eyes, where the midfield three in a straight line, Batchelor, Adam Nelson and Roddy. Now, Roddy was in an unfamiliar role today, but Roddy can do it, can do that. Roddy's a very good football player, so good football players can adapt to different roles. And I asked him something different today, and it was based upon second balls dropping, Batchelor and Roddy McLennan's energy levels, and it showed at times, breaking through the middle of the park, getting a toe on things, causing problems, and that happened, with Adam Nelson probably protecting it a bit more. The back four, with Gary Tom, Michael O'Byrne, John Evanston and Richie McKellen, again, we weren't looking for over our full-backs overdoing it today, because we had to be wary of counter-attacks. It's not a failure in that football park, not a failure, and the guys have showed and proved the levels. I asked them the day to take it out with their out with the comfort zones, and they did that. And what it probably pleased me more than anything is, some people think the club, the players can't do this, and my players played today and they wore their hearts in their sleeves, every one of them, and I liked that.
Penalty was a turning point, wasn't it?
That's right.
Up until then, Raith weren't really threatening, were they? Other than the odd set piece.
The second half was going to plan, because I always felt, my total players, the longer the game goes on, every minute it ticks away in your favour. And the penalty kick has probably just deflated us a bit. It didn't change too much, because we still had to get that goal. But it deflated us a bit, and they then got a lift at a time when they would have been into an uneasy stage of the game, because there was no room for error on their part. That a penalty kick and a set piece with five to go, we've nothing to be ashamed of today.
You were throwing a caution in the wind with the substitution just before the second goal, but I didn't have a chance to have any impact on it because they scored straight away.
I think also it's important, Martin, and as I say, the effort the guys have gave us a team, not a failure out there, not a failure, that when you're then going to change it, I didn't want it to finish 3-4, because you pick the paper up and you lose a few late goals. Pick the paper up in the morning and you lead 3-4, now it looks a comfortable result, it doesn't tell a true reflection. But I'm just glad and proud that everybody's been here, and I think everybody's had a great day. And as I say, I've said to the committee here, who deserve a lot of praise in all this as well, because without their efforts we wouldn't be standing here today in this competition this year. So they deserve a lot of praise. There's been a lot of hard work went into this in the last few weeks, and it's been the same on the played side. So what's important now is our season starts again the night, we prepare ourselves and start putting that level of performance into weekly games at our level.
Fault House next Saturday.
That's the reality for us. As I say, great occasion for us all. I think it's certainly put the rose on the map. As I say, there would have been a lot of heroes the other day that will go hopefully home and praise the junior game. Okay. That's important. Praise the junior game.
Thanks a lot, Danny.
Thank
great
you.
Stuff today. Must have been great to be part of that.
Yeah, it was a great day, but just really disappointed. It's not often you'd say that kind of thing against a championship team, but I thought we had a great first half. I thought we looked dominant. So a few chances, I think, really took me in there.
Did you think you got the ball?
I didn't get the ball, but I didn't touch him either. So
just went over.
It's just for the referee's position. He must look like he was dying to give the penalty. But
that was the turning point, wasn't it? Because we'd really contained Raith up until that point. They weren't really threatening too much.
Yeah, they hadn't cut us open. We looked really forward. If we take any chances, that would have turned it as well. Unfortunately, we couldn't do that.
Can we take heart from today though, and well, that every week has been fantastic season, isn't it?
Keep it up for the rest of the season. I'm sure it'll be good.
How's your fitness level now?
Yeah, I think.
You've been struggling a bit recent weeks as the manager, just been protecting you.
No, it's just been making changes. Yeah, I've got a squad here, so.
Enjoying life here?
Yeah, really enjoying it. I've got a really
really was enjoying football the last couple of seasons, but coming here it's a great place to play and a great bunch of boys and fans.
Okay, good stuff. Right. Cheers.
Thanks for watching this week's Junior Match of the Day. It's finished. Linlithgow 0, Raith Rovers 2. But Linlithgow fans and the team have nothing to be ashamed of. They played the best they've ever played today. They should go away from this game proud. Thanks for watching. Bye bye for now.
Late to bed, we're early to rise. Wipe the sleep from our eyes. We head to work, we catch a lift. We have a smoke, we start the shift. We open up, we start to wake. Maybe it's gonna be our day. And suddenly, we start to smile. The sun is up for a while. You may see this place in final.
Certainly put the rose on the map. As I say, we've been doing a lot of heroes every day that will go hopefully home and praise the junior game. Okay. That's important. Praise the junior game.
Thanks a lot, Danny.
Thank
Great
you.
Stuff today.